this morning with Michael Baker from Arovella Therapeutics. Michael, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. Thanks for having me on the program.
You've had your quarterly out this week, Michael. Just firstly, before we talk through some of the detail within it, give us a bit of a refresh here on Arovella.
Absolutely. So Arovella is a biotechnology company listed on the Australian Stock Exchange, and we're developing what we call an invariant natural killer T cell platform for the treatment of certain types of cancers. So it really is cutting edge immuno-oncology treatments that we're looking to develop.
And a big milestone within the quarter, the strategic collaboration with Imugene. Tell us a bit about it.
Absolutely. So I think it's a very exciting achievement and step forward for our technology, and primarily because we are working with Imugene, who are a real success story in the biotech sector. They've got a number of great platforms, but the one, of course, that we're most interested and excited by is their oncolytic platform. And what we're intending to do is take our lead therapy, which is it's what we call a CD19 targeting iNKT cell therapy, and combine it with Imugene's oncolytic virus platform. And the two together, we think, has a lot of opportunity to expand the use of ALA-101, our lead program, to use not just in blood cancers, but it opens up the possibility to take that into solid tumours. So really positive step forward for both companies, and looking forward to getting some of the data.
And you'll be looking initially at some preclinical trials here.
That's correct. So initially what we'll do is we call in vitro work. So it's more like in a dish or a test tube. And that work we can get up and running hopefully quite quickly. And then once we complete those studies, we take it a step further and we look in animal models to see how the two technologies work together.
You've also had some news here as far as your strategic review of the company's operations. What's come out of that?
Yeah, it's a really important step for the company again. Obviously, an in-depth review by the board and the management group to see where we think the most value can be delivered for the company and ultimately onto shareholders. And so a key decision out of that review was that we'll no longer focus on our Oramis platform and we'll move to close down the Perth facility. Of course, it's an important step because it does ensure that we actually preserve capital. Over the course of fiscal year 2022, the expenditure was in the order of about $1.5 million. So we refocused that capital and put that towards our iNKT cell therapy platform. So it really gives us a very clear perspective on what we're targeting moving forward and gives us the focus that we need to develop the iNKT cell therapy platform.
Well, it's the 1st of November this morning, Michael. What are your priorities as far as the remainder of the year?
Getting a lot of these studies that we've just started with Imugene up and running, and of course, continuing the manufacturing for our lead product, ALA-101. That's a key step for taking the product into clinical trials, and also for our the technology that we licensed from MD Anderson, the DKK1 peptide targeting CAR. We're looking forward to getting some data readouts towards the end of the year in Q1 and Q2 next year. So some exciting milestones to come forward, and looking forward to seeing the data come out from the platform.
Good to speak, Michael. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much, Andrew. Appreciate it.